have a lot of questions. We've been talking about this off camera, these breakthrough infections. We know there are some expected, and I do want to point out once again that 4.3 million people are vaccinated in Massachusetts, so we're talking about a fraction of 1%. But is Delta driving these breakthrough infections faster and higher? And should those of us who are fully vaccinated be concerned?
Well, it's a really important question. And I think we know now that the Delta variant is the predominant variant in our country. So all the infections we're seeing are likely related to Delta. But the good news is the vaccine is still working. The data that were released today show that just 0.2%, that's 0.2% of cases have happened in vaccinated individuals, right? So if you get a vaccine, you are orders of magnitude more protected than not being vaccinated. So the take home is that the vaccines are still working even against the Delta.
Dr. Boucher, we are seeing an uptick in vaccinations. The White House saying first doses are actually reaching their highest levels in over 2 months. Clearly, there's no magic number, but is there a level we need to reach to feel like we're really beating back the virus?
Well, every step is a good step, so it's really encouraging to see the numbers going up. We have modeling and estimates that have been done to try to predict at what level of immunity transmission of this virus will stop, right? And that's what we want. We want the virus to stop being passed around and transmitted. Some estimates are as high as 90%. So that suggests that we still have a ways to go, although it's very encouraging to see the progress, as you mentioned.
All right, we're starting to see some new mask mandates pop up every day. Salem is actually considering one tonight. Salem's already approved one for that city's schools. We know the Delta surge is certainly driving this. So what do we know about the effectiveness of masking against this variant? And would you encourage perhaps maybe a statewide mandate?
Well, we know that masks are another one of the non-pharmaceutical interventions that we have to prevent spread. Can't emphasize enough the potency of vaccines. Vaccines are orders of magnitude better in terms of their prevention. So the most important thing to do is to get vaccinated, but masks are another layer of protection. And in areas of transmission that is substantial or high, the recommendation is to mask indoors, especially when you're around people with whom you don't know their vaccination status. So very reasonable for communities to make that decision based on what's happening there in terms of transmission. And important for us to remember to mask up when we're around vulnerable people, like older people or people with compromised immune systems.
All right, Dr. Helen Boucher, Chief of Geographic Medicine and Infectious Diseases at Tufts Medical Center. Good to see you. Thank you.